For people who work in sanitation-related professions where cleanliness is critical, chemicals are regularly used, so there are a few ground rules that simply cannot be ignored. One of these is to never mix bleach and ammonia. Ever. Now, what is it about the combination of these two household cleaning products that makes their combination such a safety hazard? Well, let's start with ammonia. Ammonia is a colorless gas with a highly pungent, suffocating odor. It is a compound formed by the combination of one nitrogen and three hydrogen atoms. It is commonly found in nature and is also produced within the human body, as it's a critical component for synthesizing proteins and other complex molecules. In many countries, including the United States, ammonia is one of the most widely produced chemicals. Most of the total ammonia produced in a country is often used in agriculture as a fertilizer. In addition to that, ammonia is also used as a refrigerant gas, as well as in the manufacture of plastic, fabrics, and pesticides, and to purify water supplies. Due to its ability to clean surfaces and impart a streak-free shine, ammonia is found in many household and industrial-strength cleaning solutions. On the other hand, the term bleach is used to refer to a large group of compounds used to whiten or color lighten materials. These products are frequently used for disinfection and cleaning, as they can control or kill most types of bacteria, virus, mildew, mold, or algae. Bleach can be chlorine-based or non-chlorine-based. For example, bleaching powder, bearing the chemical name calcium hypochlorite, contains chlorine, whereas peroxidase-based bleach doesn't contain chlorine. However, in terms of general usage, the word bleach is used to refer to common household bleach, which consists of 3-8% sodium hypochlorite and trace amounts of sodium hydroxide. Thanks to its antimicrobial properties, bleach is a very common household item used for surface disinfection and for cleaning, treating fabric, and washing clothes. Looking at the properties of both ammonia and bleach, it's clear why both are very popular for cleaning surfaces. Thus, it's not surprising that these chemicals can come in contact with each other and combine. One way this combination occurs inadvertently is when people use bleach to disinfect a surface and then clean it with a liquid or soap that contains ammonia. Another way is when you use chlorine bleach to disinfect water that may contain organic matter. Also, people sometimes mix cleaning products on purpose, which, by the way, is generally considered a very bad idea. However, the fact that you should never mix ammonia and bleach is so well known because their combination may lead to the formation of dangerous, potentially hazardous byproducts as a result of certain chemical reactions that occur between the two compounds. Since sodium hypochlorite is the active ingredient in chlorine-based bleach, it may first decompose to form hydrochloric acid, which can then lead to the formation of chloramine vapors. Chloramines are a group of chemical compounds that contain chlorine and ammonia. Exposure to these toxic gases can trigger symptoms like watery eyes, nausea, coughing, shortness of breath, and irritation to the throat, nose, and eyes. This is not it, though. If ammonia is present in excess in the mixture, it can also produce toxic and potentially explosive liquid hydrazine. Although impure liquid hydrazine doesn't explode, it can certainly boil vigorously and spray hot, chemically toxic liquid around, which can endanger the safety of people nearby. The formation of such hazardous and potentially lethal products is the main reason why ammonia and bleach should never be mixed. However, if by accident you do end up mixing these two compounds, the first thing you need to do is get away from the site where these two chemicals have come together. The biggest threat in this situation is the inhalation of toxic gases. To avoid that, remove yourself from that area and try to get some fresh air immediately. This way, you'll protect yourself from the toxic chloramine vapors and other hazardous products that form as a result of their combination. Once you're in a safe environment, call for help and get yourself checked by a medical professional. Being aware of the hazardous properties of common household cleaning products is the best approach to avoid such accidents. However, if they do happen, remember to keep calm, get some fresh air immediately, and seek medical help. If you like this video, then please leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel for more animated stories on the science in our lives. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon to never miss an update from us.